Today we're going to hike up to the famous mountain called Mandango in Vilcabamba, Ecuador on experienceecuador.com. Come on, let's go. The mountain Mandango rises 3,900 feet above the southern Ecuadorian valley town of Vilcabamba, itself at 5,000 feet above sea level in the Andes Range. Vilcabamba translates as Sacred Valley in Quechua, the language of the Incas. It is known worldwide as the Valley of Longevity, with many of its residents claiming to be more than 100 years old. The life expectancy is said to be longer here due to the mineral-rich water and soil and its sacred vilca trees. This is a vilca tree. You see all of these little bumps? That's one of the identifying characteristics of this tree. This tree has been used for thousands of years for holistic healing and sorcery. The Incas would make a snuff from the seeds of this tree in order to reach higher consciousness and to be in contact with their gods and their ancestors in the spirit world. The god lying down, Mandango, appears to be an Incan Indian with his arms crossed. The name means hard face or venerable in Quechua. Ecuador is located on the Ring of Fire, with many active volcanoes and earthquakes. It is said that Mandango protects the valley from these earthquakes and other natural disasters. We're about halfway up the mountain now to Mandango, and it's very breezy out here, but the view is spectacular, as you can see. This is Vilcabamba here. Vilcabamba, Ecuador was used by Incan royalty as a playground retreat. At the height of its power, the Incan Empire stretched from the current Colombian-Ecuadorian border 3,300 miles south to Santiago de Chile. But there is a second Vilcabamba, located about 900 miles south with even more historical significance. These Incan ruins in Vilcabamba, Peru, mark the spot where the Incan Empire made its final stand against the Spanish. Mandango does more than protect those that live in the valley. It is said to be one of the four faces that points to where the lost Incan treasure is hidden. Legend says that upon learning of the execution of the Incan king Atahualpa at the hands of the Spanish conquistador Francisco Pizarro in 1533, Atahualpa's trusted general Rumanawi hid a vast fortune of gold, silver, and platinum artifacts he had collected in Quito in the Langanates mountain range to the east of Ambato. The fortune had been gathered as ransom for the release of the powerful Atahualpa and was being convoyed to Cajamarca, Peru, at the time of Atahualpa's murder. The lost treasure of the Incans has never been found. In Salango, just west of Mandango, old-timers say the lost Incan treasure was hidden in more than one location, including a cave near Mandango. The legend says that an old man, a dog, and a rooster protected the entrance to this cave. But if you brought just the right amount of food while they ate, you could sneak into the cave and you could take some of the treasure. If you brought too little food or too much food, then you wouldn't be able to get to the treasure. It would recede back into the cave and you'd get nothing. The view from the top is spectacular. Historically, people of the valley would climb Mandango every year to celebrate Cruces de Mayo, the May Crosses Festival, to pray and enjoy the spectacular view of their valley from Mandango. There are two Christian crosses on Mandango. The first can be reached after a 2-hour climb on one of four paths up the mountainside. From there, the view of the Vilcabamba Valley includes Yamborara, San Jose, Molapamba, Izcailuma, San Pedro de Vilcabamba, Uchima, Cucainama, Hacienda San Joaquin, and Amala. Climb another 20 minutes and you will reach the second cross, located right on the face of the Inca. From here, you can see seemingly endless rows of mountains, and on a clear day, the dome of the Basilica of El Cisne more than 60 miles away. The crosses are said to have been erected by Vilcabambanese to appease Mandango, which was historically in violent competition with a neighboring mountain. In the struggle of these titans, giant stones were thrown that sounded like thunderous rumbling. After brave men from the sacred village erected the second cross at the highest point, the rumbling is said to have ceased. Another very interesting thing about Mandango is that some people believe that extraterrestrials are attracted to this location because it's the third eye, they say, of the entire Andean range. So we're looking around for some extraterrestrials. None yet, but that's not to say they're not here. In 1572, the last of the Incas perished in Vilcabamba, Peru, in final battle with the Spanish. The once vast empire had ended just 100 years after it began. Or did it? Only the magic mountain called Mandango knows for sure. Thanks for watching. Please support experience-ecuador.com by becoming a patron. Log on to patreon.com/greenbirdievideo and check out all of our videos and still photography of the beautiful country that is Ecuador.